नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छु। आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी वेलकम्स यू ऑल हियर।
आई माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर प्रणव दवे वेलकम्स यू ऑल। वी आर मूविंग अहेड इन द सेकेंड लेसन, द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक। This lesson contains two parts. In both the parts, interesting ideas are given, and you will enjoy both the parts a lot. The title is The Sound of Music. The sound of music indicates that this lesson is about the music. In first part, the title, if we will read, it is little bit confusing. Evelyn Glennie, it's the name of a character. Listens to sound. Simple idea. You can listen, I can listen. But the problem is second line. Without hearing. Without hearing means you cannot listen anything else. Then the first line is little bit wrong. Evelyn Glennie listens. What is she listens? Sound. But the sound she listens, that is without hearing it. How can it be possible, yaar? It's a little bit confusing. But how much we will move ahead in our lesson, in this chapter, we will come to know what's the fact about this. One thing is very clear, that God may have taken her hearing, but the Almighty has given her back something extraordinary, and that extraordinary thing is equal to this lesson. What we hear, that she feels. The most important thing is this. What we hear, that she feels. For more deeply than any one of us who hears, she cannot, but she feels it. And that is why she expresses music so beautifully. Second thing, read following account of a person who fought against a physical disability and made her life a successful story. Keep it in your mind that whenever we live our life, we should not have any complaint to the Almighty. We are here on this earth only to fight, only to fight, only to fight. Move ahead, fight well, and ultimately once you'll be a successful person and a winner one. Fighter hamesha jeetta hai. Be like a brave fighter. Once you will love your life, you will live your life, you will love your life, you will live your life, you will win your life, and once you will prove your life. Here, when we'll move ahead, at the time, each time, in each paragraph, Evelyn Glennie's good characteristics, her disabilities, her achievements, everything about her is given over here in all the paragraphs. We'll move ahead. Rush are crowds. Chosal proposition on the underground train platform. You see here, initially only, the lesson is started with the background, how she is, where she is, and how she behaves in the situation. You see here, underground train platform. That indicates that somewhere else she is on the railway platform. Crowds, Jostle. Don't pronounce T, Jostle. Jostle. Jostle means to move here and there uselessly, without manner, roughly. And that is to get the position in the train. Next, a slight girl, looking younger than her 17 years, was nervous yet excited as she felt vibration of the approaching train. You see here, she is nervous. Why is it so? She was excited also, she was nervous also, because of one thing, and that thing is vibration. Vibration, she feels of approaching train only. She cannot listen the sound of the train, but she was able to feel the vibration. You see here, it was her first day at prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London. She was going to the prestigious institution of the world, not of the London, but of the world. And that is situated in London. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish firm. Daunting means frightening. Frightening means fearing. When you have fear, daunting, fear. And when you will move ahead, naturally, she will hesitate. She was a fresh teenager. She was not having any detailed idea about the academy, about the music. And yet, she was very excited to be there in Music Academy of London. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than the most. In all the aspects of life, we lead our life, but that life would be always full of challenges, full of struggles. In any unknown, strange place, when we move, we always face challenges and troubles. But here, she faced the bigger challenge than others, most of the other people. Why is it so? The reason is also given here, and the reason is what? That she was profoundly deaf. She was not having any capacity to listen anything. Another word is given there just above it: aspiring musician. A person who wants to be a musician is known as
aspiring musician. She wanted to become a musician, and for that purpose only she was there. This but the paragraphs are for Evelyn's own physical disabilities and her achievements. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Keep it in your mind that loss of hearing would be always gradual. It will not be a sudden attack. Never it will be. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8 years old girl Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name, but she didn't move. I suddenly realized she had not heard anything else, says Isabel Glennie. Isabel Glennie is her mother. When she was 8 years old, once upon a time she was at a place, at a music concert or somewhere else. They called her name. They called her name, those who were there in that function. But the thing is what? She didn't move to play a piano. She didn't move to play a piano. Why is it so? Because she didn't listen anything else. At that time, she was 8 years old. The first paragraph is 17 years old. Second paragraph is when she was 8 years old. For quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from the friends and teachers. This is human tendency. What a deficiency or what problem we are having, we are used to conceal it. Conceal it, we are used to hide it. We will not reveal the fact. And so that only we should be very near to our friends, we should be very near to our teachers, so that any problems of life, we should, we must, we can share with our friends and teachers. But by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated, means had gone down, and her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist, ENT specialist. Why is it so? Because she was not having capacity to come up in her education. In this condition, she must be under the observation of an ENT.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for joining us. Thank you. Thanks a lot for joining us.